Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Wow, I really screwed up back in episode 103.1 and 103.2 talking about how to create that XY chart with multiple series. I created it with a single series and then kept adding new data. It turns out that you don't have to do that at all, and several people wrote in with the solution to this. Basically, you set up your data like this with X1 and Y1 here like I had done, but then below that put the X2 values and the Y2 values over in column C, X3 values back in column A, and then the Y3 values over in column D, and so on down the way. And then when we create a XY chart from that whole big set, we get all of the XY points correctly in the right spots, and you just have to go through and format them as I did back in episode 103.2. So thanks to everyone for sending those in. I'll be spending a lot of money on postage for sending Excel master pins out there. That's the great thing about Excel. You can think that you know almost everything, and you can always be surprised, and I'm constantly surprised on this podcast. Thanks for that great tip. Great way to solve that problem. I appreciate all the folks who wrote in. Watch your mailbox for your Excel master pins for that one. For everyone else, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.